Well, I am a wife, a mother of four, a proud mother of four awesome children. I love to say Medina native, so when you get the y'alls and all that, you know exactly where it comes from. / executive director of a nonprofit organization, an awesome nonprofit organization called For Our Daughters. Well, in 2011, when I was 28 years old, I was diagnosed with stage 2 breast cancer. The thing about being diagnosed when I was 28 is when I was 26, I had breast cancer and my doctors kept pushing me off. I went for my yearly checkup when I was 27. My doctors pushed me off. So when they found it when I was 28, I actually had stage 2 breast cancer, so it began to spread. I realized how much I didn't know about my family history when my doctors started to ask me questions about your family history, which is routine, and I couldn't answer any of the questions. A light went off in my head and I said, holy cow, not only do I not know my family history, but I'm not teaching my daughter or my son their family history. So For Our Daughters literally came from my vow to do better for my daughter. I did write a book. About a year ago, August of 2016, over a year ago now, I sat down at my computer and said, you know what, I'm just gonna write a book. I don't know about what, but I just started typing. Put it down. Late last year, late 2017, God woke me up out of my sleep and said, get up and finish that book. So I got up, started typing. In 2 weeks, I had it written out and ready to start the editing process. That's how much it flowed. I could not stop typing. I was up early in the morning and I stayed up late at night just to get it all out. Yes, people will be able to get it on Amazon, BNN. You'll be able to get it from the Westbow Press website as well as I'll have some on my website too. I really wanted to pick something that said hope. So I did some research, looked up the different colors, things that signify hope. So you'll see a little bit of all of that on the cover. And also before hope really magnifies itself, you know, you go through some rough times and then when hope kicks in, you get to see what hope looks like. Hope looks like survival to me. It's not always, you know, how we make it to be sunshine and rainbows. You have to go through a process to get there and to realize how important it is. So hope, the cover will reveal what hope looks like, at least in my view. But also what's inside the book will show you the steps that I took to get to hope. So hope looks different for everyone. Yeah, I would say if you're currently going through it, that's where, I guess, hope kicks in. It's in those tough times. It's not like, again, it's not all sunshine and rainbows. For someone to have hope, they've had to endure something. So while you're going through it, you have to find that space. And for me, it was in prayer. It was in finding out some of the things that I like. You'll see in the book, I talk about different processes that I took or different processes that God took me through to get me where I needed to be, to kind of see the light at the end of the tunnel. But hope looks different for everyone. And if you're a woman going through it, going through some rough times, I would definitely say find out where you need to dig to find it. Yeah. Number one, my children. Gave me the most inspiration, because one of the things that I really tell them about and take pride in is being transparent. And this book kind of takes the readers back to my childhood and some things that I went through that some people don't know about. Most people just know about the breast cancer and how I'm a survivor and how I was diagnosed at a young age, but some people don't know some of the things that I've been through, such as a divorce and different, you know, things in my childhood that helped form Mercedes to who she is today. I'm super excited about this foreword. I actually called on my old pastor. When I lived in Olean, I went to a church there called Rock of Revelation Church, and my old pastor, Pastor J. Anthony Gilbert, I called him up and said, can you write a foreword? Because he knows me, he knows my life when I first rededicated my life back to Christ and my walk, and he knows how serious I am about this thing. So when I called him, he was honored to do it. I can't wait for all of the readers to read the foreword, because that'll give you a taste of who Mercedes truly is as well. If you were a woman going through what you're going through and reading the book, I think you would feel a sense of, I'm not alone. A lot of times we feel embarrassed to talk about some of the things that we're going through because we think people will judge us. But there are some things that I put in the book that people don't know about me, some of the struggles that I had that might raise some eyebrows with some people. But the whole point was to be real and transparent, because we cannot get to the bottom of things and change things until we're real. Hi, I'm Mercedes Wilson. Please purchase my book, Hope, June 15th, 2018. Also, follow me on social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, you know the deal.